Welcome to an introduction to decimal notation. In this lesson, we will read a number in decimal notation and also write a decimal using fraction notation. Welcome to an introduction to decimal notation. In this lesson, we will read a number in decimal notation, write a decimal using fractional notation, and also compare and order numbers in decimal notation. Decimal notation is used to write numbers according to place value in base 10. A decimal point is used to separate whole numbers from numbers that are less than 1. So looking at the place value chart below, here's the decimal point. To the left, we have the whole numbers. We have the ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, and ten thousands. To the right of the decimal point, we have numbers that are less than 1. We have the tenths, hundredths, thousandths, ten thousandths, and so on place value. To help us model decimals, we'll use the following base 10 blocks. We'll let this block be the unit block, and then because it takes 10 flats to equal one whole, one flat is equal to 1/10 as a fraction, or 0.1 as a decimal. It takes 100 rods, or 100 longs, to make one whole, so one rod is equal to 1/100 as a fraction, or 0.01 as a decimal. And it takes 1,000 bits to make up one whole, and therefore 1 bit is equal to 1/1000th as a fraction, or 0.001 as a decimal. So to the right of the decimal point, we have the tenths, hundredths, thousandths, and ten thousandths place value. Here we're asked to read the following numbers using place value, and then write the decimal using fraction notation. So we first have 4.3. To help us better understand this, let's represent 4.3 using our base 10 blocks as defined before. So because we have a 4 in the ones place value, we have 4 ones. And then because we have a 3 to the right of the decimal point, this represents 3/10, which should be 3 flats. Again, each of these flats is equal to 1/10, so we have 3/10. This is actually how we say the number. We say 4 and 3/10, which means as a mixed number, we would have 4 3/10. If we're asked to express this as a fraction, though, we would express this as an improper fraction. Because each one is equal to 10 flats, or 10/10, we have 40/10 plus 3/10, or 43/10. Another way to find this improper fraction is to multiply the denominator times the whole number. 4 times 10 is 40. Add the numerator of 3, which gives us 43, giving us 43/10. Let's look at a second example. Here we have 2.12, so modeling this using our base 10 blocks. Here's our 2. We have a 1 in the tenths place value, so we have 1/10, or 1 flat. And then we have a 2 in the hundredths place value, so we have 2 longs, or 2 rods. So this is 2/100. So we have 2 and 1/10 and 2/100, but we normally don't read this number this way. Looking at the values that are less than 1, we obtain common units, which means we can perform an exchange for this 1 flat. We can exchange this 1 flat for 10 longs, or 10 rods, which would look like this. So here we have 2. Now instead of having 1 flat, we have 10 longs, which shows us that 1/10 is equal to 10/100, and we still have 2/100 here. Notice how we have a total of 10 plus 2, or 12/100. This is how we say this number, 2 and 12/100. Looking at the decimal again, notice how we do have a 12 to the right of the decimal point, and because the rightmost digit, which is a 2, is in the hundredths place value, again we say 2 and 12/100. Which means as a mixed number, we do have 2 and 12/100. But notice how this fraction does simplify. 12 and 100 share a common factor of 4. So we could divide out the common factor of 4. So simplified, we'd have 2 3/25. Now this is a mixed number, so as a fraction, our denominator would still be 25. And the numerator would be 25 times 2, that's 50, plus 3, that's 53. So 2 12/100 as a fraction is 53/25. For our third example, we're given 1.125, so using our base 10 blocks, here's 1. Because we have a 1 in the tenths place value, we have 1 flat, here's the 1/10. Because we have a 2 in the hundredths place value, we have 2 longs for 2/100. And then we have a 5 in the thousandths place value, so we have 5 bits. So we have 1 and 1/10 and 2/100 and 5/1000. But this is not how we normally say this number. We take a look at all the values that are less than 1, and we get common units. We want to convert all these to thousandths. So because it takes 10 bits to equal 1 long, each of these longs is 10/1000. So we have a total of 20/1000, meaning 2/100 is equal to 20/1000. And because it takes 100 bits to equal 1 flat, 1/10 is equal to 100/1000. So notice how we have 1 and 125/1000. So as a mixed number, again, we have 1 and 125/1000. Looking at our decimal again, notice how we do have the number 125. And because the rightmost digit is in the thousandths place value, we read this 1 and 125/1000. Now this fraction does simplify. 125 does divide evenly into 1,000. So if we divide out the common factor of 125, this would be equal to 1 1/8. Again, 8 times 125 is equal to 1,000. So as a fraction, 1 1/8 would have a denominator of 8. The numerator would be 8 times 1, which is 8 plus 1, which gives us 9/8. Again, 1 is equal to 8/8, so we have 8/8 plus 1/8, which gives us 9/8 as the fraction for 1 and 125/1000. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.